Alright, so in this video, what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at adding in additional geometry to the head area and the tail area. The problem is right now, I have essentially, as you can see in my photo reference, a need for a more bulbous area around the head and a more flattened area around the tail. And I just can't get that with the current amount of geo that's here. To do this with NURBS geometry, what I have to do is add in additional isoparms. This is going to be slightly different from the polygon process, which we're going to examine later. To add in extra isoparms, first I'm going to select one half of my model, right-click, and choose the isoparm component mode. This will turn my model a light blue color. As we saw earlier, if I click on one of these isoparms, it will turn that isoparm yellow. Click off of that. However, if I click and drag this isoparm, which is currently shown red, into a new area, I'll get a dotted yellow line, as you can see here. This is a potential new isoparm. It hasn't been created yet. In fact, I can create several new potential isoparms if by holding down Shift, I continue dragging out these potential lines. The process is actually very similar to, if you're used to Photoshop, creating guides off of your rulers on your canvas. It actually feels much the same in how you're creating it. So I'm going to create maybe two new isoparms around the head. Maybe that'll be enough. We'll see if that is in a second. I'll hold down Shift and maybe add in another one around the tail. Let's see if we can create one more going along the top of the chicken. So I'll draw out a fourth one right here. And you'll see the whole sort of coalition of yellow lines that we have, these dotted yellow lines, running across the model. Now again, I can't say enough, these aren't actually isoparms yet. They're potential isoparms, until I physically create them from the potential that's here. To add these isoparms in, I'm going to go to Edit NURBS and choose Insert Isoparms. Doing so, as you see here, will now add additional geometry into the model. It returns back to object mode, and you can see things start to work. Now I have additional geometry that can be used to change the proportions of this form. I'll go into Control Vertex mode by right-clicking and choosing Control Vertex. And I'll grab my Lasso Select tool from the toolbar and just grab a little selection over this head. I'll hit R for the Scale tool, and now I can scale some of these up right around the head section. I'll move some of these around a little bit, and I can pull this front area out. Now be careful though, as I said earlier, you don't want to accidentally open up one of these center lines. So make sure you're not moving any of these control vertices off the center line. I'm going to grab just these three, and with the Move tool, widen them out. In fact, you know what? I may want to grab a fourth one as well. And let's see, there might be another control vertice right around in here. What I'm looking for is that I want a vertice that I can use to maybe round out a cheek section for this chicken. I don't actually see it though, but my guess is if I go into wireframe mode by hitting 4, then it might be hiding out inside. And look at that, there it is. I'll hit 5 to return a smooth shaded. The thing is, since control vertices sit off of the model itself on a NURB surface, they can sometimes be hard to locate. So by jumping into wireframe mode once in a while, you can sometimes find the ones that you were missing. And here I can kind of add in the width of my cheeks. If I've got a very skinny chicken, if I've got a very fat chicken, you get the idea. A couple more manipulations, and I think we'll have it. So to me, that feels like a successful body to this chicken. I hit F8 twice to return to object mode, or I can right click and choose object mode. So we've got two halves. You know what, I've gotta put these two back together. That's my lingering problem. I never want to leave these as just two halves open. I must combine these two parts. Well, with polygon models, as we're going to see in future videos, polygon models require you to combine your parts. It's a very similar process with nerve surfaces called attaching. Since we detached these two halves earlier, I'm going to now reattach my two sections. So drag a selection over both of your halves, or select one and hold down shift and select the other, doesn't really matter. And go to Edit Nerves, and you're going to want to choose Attach Surfaces. However, I'm going to go to the Options box here. This is a critical option. Connect or Blend, Blend Bias, and Keep Originals. Well, let's examine some of these. First of all, I don't want my original halves and a new completed one. So I'm going to turn off Keep Originals, which will just give me the new completed model. I can choose Connect or Blend. I prefer to have Blend. And Blend Bias, as you see right now, is set to 50%. It's halfway in the middle of the slider. That will blend the two halves evenly. Connect will physically connect the two, but you won't actually get a transition of curvature. So I've got Blend, the Blend Bias at 50%, and Keep Originals turned off, and I'll hit Apply. Now on my version, it's going to jump back to looking angular, but when I hit 3, my curvature returns. So I'll close out of my Attach Surfaces options. And I've got a very nice looking mesh. Problem is, let me right click on the model, and I will choose Control Vertex. Let's take a look what's happening here. Even though my model has been attached, it's still open. I need to close this surface up. To do that, I'm going to go to Edit Nerves and choose Open slash Close Surfaces, and I'm going to go to the Options box. Now, what we have here as well are options that are allowing me to choose which direction to close the surface on. I can choose U or V or both, and the shape, I can either ignore the current shape, preserve it, or blend it. And usually as well, you want Keep Originals turned off. Well, let's examine what happens here. I'm going to start off with surface direction U and hit Apply. Blending here looks like it just blends, as you can see, straight through from tip to tip. And that's obviously not what I want. If I choose both, it will blend my seam and my tip. And again, that's not exactly what I'm after. If I choose just V, it will create a blend straight through the center of the model. And everything is going to work itself out. Now, this is with preserve chosen. If I choose to blend, I get a much more accurate blending. It doesn't actually insert isoparms onto the form. So by choosing surface direction V and shape blend, I get a pretty accurate little piece. I'll hit close. Now, since I've done a lot of operations recently, inserting isoparms, attaching my surfaces, closing the surfaces, now is a really good time to go to Edit and delete your history by going to Delete All by Type, History. I'm also going to go into the hypergraph, Window, Hypergraph Hierarchy. You'll see I've got one node currently in the hypergraph, Nerve Sphere Attached Surface 1, which isn't very detailed to me. I'm going to right-click on it and choose Rename and call this Bird underscore Body. I'll hit Control-G and my group I will now rename chicken underscore toy. And now I've got a group. I've got an individual piece inside of it. And in the next video, we're going to take a look at adding in the wings, the comb, and the waddle.